Hi and welcome everyone. In this video, we are going to talk about Object.assign, which is another important method of the object function. And what it do, it actually gives you the target object from the source object. So there is a scenario where you wanted to copy one object into another object, then this is the best way of doing it. What we need to do, Object.assign, this is the target object. And this is the source object you have. So it will give you the target new deep copy of that object. Okay, so consider there is an object X which is having property A70, B90. Now you wanted to create another object from this, right? A new object. Then what you can do, you can just pass X. So it will give you the new copy which is isolated from the original copy of X. Okay, so let's do this something like this. X is the object and I wanted to create the Y as an object, object.assign X. Okay, so let's do Y dot C equal to 90, or let's put it as 60. Okay, so X, the value of X is still having A and B, but Y is now having A, B, C, right? Because it's a deep copy, it's not changing whatever is happening on Y object, is not hampering anything on X object, right? It's a deep copy. Object.assign, this is the target object, this is source object, and you are getting the new object out of it. So the Y memory reference is totally different from X. In Y, you added a C property. Okay, that is now not available on X, or whatever you add X on X, that will be not be available on to the Y. Okay, A, B, C, you added a D, so Y is having all these and X will be having D property, right? So this is the difference we added, right? So object.assign is actually used to do the deep copy, or you can also say it is used to merge the properties. Consider that I have a 10, b 40. It can have a number of arguments, right? So what it will give me, it will merge that and it will give me the new object. So how the object.assign works, it try to copy or override the properties from the right to left. C70 will override B40, okay, both are different, so it will merge. Then B40, C70 will override A10, all are different, so it will merge. Otherwise, if you see, if I pass something like this, can you define what will be the output, right? It will A70 override A40, both are the same properties. Now A70 again will override the A10 property. So you are getting A70 property. Okay, the thing is, okay, I'm able to do the deep copy of an object using object.assign, object.create, or there are other ways. When I say deep copy means, let's you are having this object A70, right? Now you are assigning Y equal to X, and what you are doing, Y dot A is 80, right? X is also now 80, right? You changed Y, that totally impacted X, so it's a shallow copy. It's both are sharing the reference. But when you did using object.assign, it will change everything. You just pass your X object and assign it to the Y object, right? Now Y dot uh, 60, so your X is still unimpacted, right? Okay, the thing is, we did it in the wrong way. X is already having A80, we created a Y, and now I added a property Y at 60, right? Maybe the duplicate declaration. So okay, I didn't do a deep copy here. So to do a deep copy, this is the target object I am creating from X. Okay, now if I add something to the Y, that is not available to X. So keep that in mind. I'm creating a deep copy, I'm creating a new object from X. If you just pass a single argument, it means they can, it's same, it is sharing the reference. So let's try to repeat that so you are clear on this. Okay, so this is x, and consider x is having only a is 20, and you creating the y object from it. Now if you do y dot b equal to 80, then x is also impacted, right? So if you do the how to confirm it, x dot underscore underscore for 2, right? Okay, let's do the comparison of I am assigning. Okay, I think I have spoiled the answer. It's true, right? So whatever you have on the x, both are pointing to the same memory reference until unless you didn't pass the deep copy object like this. You need to create a new object out of it, then x. So it will create a y as a separate copy. Okay. This is the drama of object.assign, but there is a particular case. Right now, whenever we create an object, all the properties are enumerable, configurable, writable, all are by default false. Let's check that out. Okay, sorry for that. I'm doing too much for x. Okay, let's put a 70 and object dot get on property descriptor. And I will be passing x object, and there is a property a. Okay, you can see all the configurable, writable, enumerable, all are true. But what if I create a new property on the object and put the configurable, enumerable as a false? You can see object.create. This is my object. Let's put okay, foo is fine. It is an object which is having foo 1. And it is creating bar and baz as a new values having value equal to true. So at this time it is non-enumerable property will be false. Let's see that. So object dot get on property descriptor, and I'm passing object here, and I wanted to get the property descriptor of bar. You can see the writable is false, enumerable is false, configurable is false. So we need to talk about this enumerable property. If enumerable property is false, then it will not get copied into the new object we are creating. So this is the same example, same sample I'm talking about. So enumerable is false, here enumerable is true. So whenever you are creating the new deep copy object, so this is the deep copy I'm doing, creating copy of this object. I'm doing a deep copy. So this deep copy will have baz only available, not bar. But if I say enumerable true here also, okay, let's add this property true in both. Now both are enumerable, so you can see both the properties are there. So a lot of people misunderstood this concept that object.assign will create a whole new copy, but it depends on the property of that object. If all are enumerable as a true, then all will get copied. But you can do some customization. You can put the enumerable false for some object properties that will not get copied to the new object. Okay, this is all about object.assign, which is used for merging the objects, which is used for creating the deep copy, or which is used to put some restriction also while doing copying.